This is the day that the Lord has made. We all be glad and rejoice in it. I don't know about you, but I am glad to be in this presence. I'm glad to be around you all. If you was in Sunday school this morning, you would have heard about praising the Lord with joy. Amen. Scripture say, enter into the gates with thanksgiving and his courts with praise. He said, bless his name because he is good. Does anybody believe that God is good? You don't have to wait on the praise team or the choir, but you ought to give God praise for what God has done for you. I don't know about you, but it was hard for me to make it here this morning. But God guided me through. Ain't God good? Everybody watch the news besides me. Somebody died last night. Somebody died this morning. But God has given us another chance for us to come here and say, Lord, thank you for another day. This is a great day to be in the house of the Lord because it's the first Sunday. It's the Sunday where we recognize Jesus for what he done for us on Calvary. Ain't that a good day to be in the church? Then we got three men here that I believe that are set apart. That's going to be ordained today. Amen. That's a good thing. And then hopefully we can have a good word from the Lord. And then we can say, Lord, thank you for all three incidents. Amen. What about you? Are you going to join me on today and have some fun in the house of the Lord? Are you going to join me on today and recognize that if it had not been for the Lord, you wouldn't be here? Will you recognize what God has done? And join me to welcome every guest that we have in the house on today. Look, if you got any cases that you need dismissed, we got the judge in the house. But it's got to be in what's that county? We got me in Washington County, though, so I know I'm nobody here. I said that because we ain't got nobody here living in Washington County. Amen. Who? Robertson County. Now, we ain't got nobody here with no Robertson County, so we can't get our cases dismissed. But we do have a judge in the house on today. She's here to... And we got a dentist in the house. Is they from Houston? Where the dentist at? She might get some business in here on today. This is the day that God has set up for us to enjoy all the benefits that he has available for us on today. I don't know about you, but I'm happy today. I got three certificates in my hand. Ordination certificates. Amen. We got a birthday to celebrate on today. This young man over here, 35 years old. How many know that? That is a blessing for us. Look, I'm way on down the road, but I did enjoy when I was 35. 35 is an important number to me because I've been saved 35 years. 35 years I've been saved. I got saved when he was born. Amen. And I'm almost 65. You may well say 65. God has given me enough time to carry out the desires of the flesh. He gave me 30 years. He said, now for the rest of your life, spend time uplifting me. You might be here today. I'm going to give you an invitation now. I'm going to give it to you in the end. You might be here today, and it might be your day that God want to stop you from doing all that stuff that you was doing. And join us in trying to draw people to Christ. Amen. Amen. That's a good thing. I'm going to get out the way. But I do want to recognize our visitors in the day. I really don't understand why all these people would come to celebrate Robert. You know what I'm saying? You know, I just don't understand why y'all are here to celebrate Robert. And then why would she drive all the way from, she said, Washington, Robertson County? To be here with this man here. Amen. And then we got another man that's standing. I don't know where he at. The Deacon John, you know what I'm saying? He came way down from Victoria. I just don't understand it. But this man over here, he gonna get ordained today. You know what I'm saying? So we thank God for all he has done.
Amen.
Yes, God. I'm gonna get out the way, but I want you to remain seated, because I want to make sure that I welcome all of you. I want you to know that you're welcome, and we have a special song that's dedicated to every person that's here that's not a member. Amen. Here we go.
From the 96th division of Psalm 1 through 6. Sing to the Lord a new song. Sing to the Lord all the earth. Sing to the Lord, praise his name. Proclaim his salvation day after day. Declare his glory among the nations, his marvelous deeds among all peoples. For great is the Lord and most worthy of praise. He is to be feared above all gods. For all the gods of the nations are idols, but the Lord made the heavens. Splendor and majesty are before him. Strength and glory are in his sanctuary. This morning I have read the 96th division of Psalm 1 through 6, and may the reading be a blessing to the hearers, doers, and followers of the word. Thank you.
Amen. Hallelujah. Thank you, God, for one more opportunity for us to just bless your name. May we all bow. Lord, in the precious name of Jesus, we come to you, Lord, just to say thank you.
Thank you,
God, for our yet spare lives, God. Thank you, God, for waking us up this morning to a day that was not promised. Thank you, God, for allowing us to assemble here today to give your name all the glory, honor, and praise.
I'm going to be in the house of the Lord. I said, God is good.
great. His greatness is great. Like it's a land of children. Hallelujah. Praise God.
Hallelujah.
Oh, praise him because he's ready to be praised. I praise him because he woke me up this morning. I put it on my table. I know my God. A long time ago.
Amen.
I said, Lord, I do what you want me to do.
Yeah.
I said, Lord, I go where you want me to go.
Yeah.
I want to follow you, Jesus.
Amen.
I want to follow you. God, and God is good to us. God is good.
Yeah.
Now, I can't believe why people don't want to serve a God like you do.
Yeah.
I don't understand. But how can I not serve God?
Woo.
You've been too good to me. He brought me out of things that I didn't think I could get out of.
Oh,
yeah. But he brought me out. Hey.
Hallelujah.
Hey. I will follow. I'll go where you want me to go.
Yes, God.
Hallelujah.
Yes, God.
Hallelujah. You know this is first Sunday.
Hallelujah.
The first Sunday we used to sing about the blood.
Yes, God.
Time to have one song about the blood.
Okay.
One thing about the blood, it'll never stray away.
Yes.
God keep us with his blood.
Yes.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Amen. 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 I want us to give Sister Audrey Thorne a hand. Let's give her a hand. Amen. As she said, I will follow.
Praise God.
Thank you, we'll be right back. And giving what you owe him. We ask that you do that at this time. This time we give our tithes and our offering. If you've already given your tithe at your other church, we ask that you just, you know, give us an offering. And we'll really appreciate it. Amen. Jim is going to come. Makes no difference what you're going through. You're going to make it. Thank you.
Thank you, God.
I'm sorry, I'm sorry. I don't want to.
Thank you, Lord, for the love of God. Thank you for the deed. Be well. Amen.
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 Hey, their sins and be baptized. Yes. Amen. Amen. Pastor, how many songs I have left?
That's it.
You can do any of my songs, but you can do any of them. Amen. Amen. That's it. Praise God. Come on, give God a hand, praise. Amen. Amen. You gave it. You said that was it. Okay, I'll give one more then. Come on, baby. This is my song. This is, come on, baby. Because this is a testimony to me. God did it.
Thank you.
team, they've done a marvelous job.
Amen.
We thank God for them allowing me to put in another song. Amen. That was my fault. I wanted to hear Jeremy's song. Amen.
Yeah.
And it's just good that, you know, people will allow you to make changes. Amen. Sometimes people get mad, fuss, fight, but these men, these women, they just went right along with it. And I just like Jeremy singing that song.
Amen.
He stepped in the water, says, chill his body, but didn't do nothing to his soul. Amen. Amen. So we thank God for them. We thank God for all of you. Today is the first Sunday. We will recognize Jesus for what he's done for us on Calvary. Amen. Is anybody glad about what God done for us on Calvary? I don't know about you, but like I told you earlier, God gave me 30 years to carry out the desires of my flesh. Come on, help me if you can. But now for 35, I've been trying to do all I can for the Lord. And hopefully I can get 35 more. You know what I'm saying? But I'm sold out to the Lord. Amen. I'm sold out to the Lord because he's been too good to me. And then I really believe that I got three men that I'm going to ordain on today.
Amen.
Reverend Stewart, you know, he's come a long way in the Lord.
Yes, sir.
Amen. He's come a long way in the Lord. I'm going to ordain him that, you know, he'd probably be able to marry his own daughter now. You know, with that ordination, he can marry people.
Yeah.
Amen. I'm ordaining Patrick today, the Congo player over there, and he will be our head deacon.
Praise the Lord.
Amen. Amen. And then Robert Brown is probably why the place is packed on today. You know what I'm saying? Folks just crazy about them some Robert.
Amen.
Way from Victoria way down here just to celebrate Robert. Robert is an extra extraordinary man.
All right.
And I thank God for him.
Amen.
And I'm going to ordain him as a deacon on today. So I have structured my sermon towards Christ and these ones that's getting ordained on today. Amen. It's coming from 2 Corinthians chapter 5 verses 14 through 21. Coming from the New American Standard Version, there you will find these words if you're going to be with me. Say, for the love of Christ controls us, having concluded this, that one died for all, therefore all died. And he died for all so that they who live might no longer live for themselves, but for him who died and rose again on their behalf. Therefore, from now on, we recognize no one according to the flesh, even though we have known Christ according to the flesh. Yet now we know him in this way no longer. This is my love. I love this one. Say so. Therefore, if any man or anyone is in Christ, he is a new creature. The old things passed away. Behold, new things have come. Now all these things are from God, who reconciled us to himself through Christ and gave us the ministry, Robert. Ministry, Reverend Stewart. The ministry, Deacon Patrick, of... I got messed up. Of reconciliation.
Amen.
Amen. Namely, that God was in Christ reconciling the world to himself, not counting their trespasses against them, and he has committed to us the word of reconciliation. Therefore, we as ambassadors for Christ, as though God were making an appeal through us, we beg you, on behalf of Christ, be reconciled to God. Last scripture, he made him who knew no sin to be sin on our behalf, so that we might become the righteousness of God in him. Amen. I just want to talk just a little while about control by the beating and blood of Christ.
Amen.
Controlled by the beating and the blood of Christ. Let us bow. Gracious Father, Lord, we come now in the name of Jesus, asking you, Father, for forgiveness of sin. And we ask, Lord, that you will give us a little time to uplift your word and uplift these men. And it's in Jesus' name that we pray. Amen. Thank God. I believe that Robert and Patrick and Reverend Stewart are controlled by what Christ done for them on Calvary. And it's probably some more in here on today that you recognize and you realize that Christ got beat down for us. Amen. And he beat him so bad till he shed a lot of blood that he could have came down. If he wanted to, he could have called angels down and done away with all of these people, but Christ cared so much about us. Can I make it personal? Put your name there. Christ cared so much about you, whoever you are, whatever your name is, that he stayed on the cross. And once you realize that, that ought to control you to be a better person. Amen. And I got on my footnotes. I didn't want to put it on the board and say, but church, every step we make, it should be a praise party. Amen. Every meal we eat, should be a praise party. How many know there's some people that really don't have no food? You know what I'm saying? Every dollar that you have in your pocket should be a praise party. Come on, help me if you can. Every day we get up and be able to walk to the restroom. Come on, help me if you can. By yourself, that should be a praise party. Guess what else? And every time we look up at the cloud, you know the cloud that came down and Jesus got on and got up out of here. Every time you are able to look at all these things. See, sometimes we miss out on our praise. But we need to be praising the Lord for every good and perfect gift. How many know there's a blessing to go from one place to another? People are dying today over little penny stuff. You know what I'm saying? But we thank God for all the people that are here today. We thank God that God is still calling men unto himself. And by way of Robert Brown, by way of Kenneth Stewart, by way of Brother Patrick, you know what I'm saying? He are calling them to a different life. I got confidence in this Brother Ben. I got confidence in Robert Brown.
Amen.
I got confidence in this man's he bringing the water.
Amen.
I got confidence in this man.
Amen.
Can I just tell you a little joke about Reverend Stewart right quick? We were having something here at the church. We had an ice chest that was full of soda water. Then we poured two or three bags of ice on the soda water. And I wanted to move the ice chest in my truck. But some kind of way I said something that made him mad. And so I was trying to get some other men to help me move the ice chest because I tried to move it and I couldn't move it. He told me, man, get out of the way, Pastor. He picked the ice chest up by himself and walked to my truck with it. I say, man, what kind of man is this? You know what I'm saying? Man, he picked it up by himself. So it's just good to have somebody like that on your side, you know what I'm saying? That can pick up ice chests, man, you know what I'm saying? And not only pick them up, just walk with it like it wasn't nothing. But I do have confidence in this brother. But every time we get a chance to talk about God, we ought to think about his grace and his son. Because God did not have to do what he did. But God died for everybody in here. Even though we are recognizing them today, God loves you too. If you're here in the house today, God loves you too. And God, see, when you go home, y'all read 1 Peter chapter 4. And it'll let you know that God has already given you enough time to carry out all that stuff that you were doing. He said, now is the time for you to, what, start serving him. Is there anybody here beside me that you believe that God could have took you out way back then, but God has given you some grace? God gave you a job, God, you got a house, you got a car. You ought to be. Every time you look around, y'all be giving God some praise. See, look at, I called Robert the other day. I told him, I said, man, look at, I had three things I want to tell him, but I, one of them, I should have wrote them down. But look, we just need to listen more. That was the first thing I told him. Listen more, you know what I'm saying? Find out, so you can find out a whole lot about a person if you just listen to him. Huh? I, you know what I'm saying? I'd like to hear you talk. Let me hear you talk. But the next thing I told him, that sometimes you need to turn your radio off. Because God probably may have a word for you. But you got a music so loud you can't even hear. Sometimes we just need to hear God. God got things to say to us, you know what I'm saying? He got wisdom that he got stored up for us, but we got all this stuff going on. Yeah, you know, we need some peace from the Lord. Sometimes you just have to be quiet. You know what I'm saying? Now, God ain't always quiet. God like to have fun too. But now, every now and then, you need to turn that stuff off and listen to him who got all that wisdom. You know what I'm saying? Am I making any sense up in here? I believe that Robert is a great man. I believe that Rev Stewart is a great man. And Patrick, that was a great man. I got confidence, and I'm putting that on them. I'm saying, you know what I'm saying? They might have some other ideas they might want to think about, but after I put all this pressure on them today, they're going to say, man, look here, Pastor Ford told all them people about what he expects out of me. So it's certain things that they really should not be doing. I ain't going to say could not be doing, because they didn't do it if they want to. But they should not do things that will disappoint the Lord. Amen. See, I try to live my life in a way where God will be pleased. I ain't worried about what you think. See, I'm scared of the Lord, man, because I can't see him. Every now and then, Rev Stewart might come at me, but I can see him. I can't see the Lord. Man, he come at you all kind of ways and just take you all the way out. But God is in love with these men. I'm just singling them out on today. Don't think that God ain't in love with you, because this is their day. People have come from out of town to witness this ceremony on today. And that's why this message is tied in to them. And they believe in what happened on that hill called Calvary. Amen. They believe that they stretched him wide, they lift him high, and he hung his head and he died. But before he did all that, they beat him all night long. See, y'all need to remember that, not just on the first Sunday, but every time you get up, y'all ought to be thinking about what God took for you. So I put my name there. And I think I preached last week that, you know, that if we stop looking at what somebody else done, and focus on your part in the situation. Come on, help me if you can. See, I talked about a man that mattered last week. A man that mattered. Said brought that woman in, accused of abduction. Come on, help me if you can. But now, how in the world can that woman, or could that woman, have committed adultery if she didn't have a man with her? But they did not admit to their sin. They want to look at what she had did. We got men like that today, you know what I'm saying? They want to get divorced, they want to leave, they want to say this and say that. But you are just as... I'm talking about a man that now. You're going to recognize your part in the situation. Everybody came all about themselves. Huh? Y'all ain't trying to hear me on today. But it caused me not to accuse people unless I'm accusing myself. Always talking about somebody else and I ain't never put myself. See, if you look at your own self long enough, most times it shuts you up. Huh? He told me, cast the first stone. What'd they do? They left. They left because they was just as guilty. Amen. Amen. So what I'm saying to you, you know what I'm saying? If you got something going on in your house, you need to go back and get that straight, man. You know what I'm saying? We ain't trying to deal with no divorces here. Am I making any sense? We trying to be reconciled. And if I read this right, they gave Robert, Rev Stewart and Patrick the ministry of reconciliation. So they ought to be in the business of trying to reconcile situations, reconcile people that act in the way they used to act. How many know that if you look at an individual long enough, you'll see yourself? Man, you ain't always done right. You ain't always live right. Come on, help me if you can. Is there anybody beside me that ain't on it? I know the song says all you got to do is live right. But it just ain't all that easy sometimes. It's easy, but, yeah. But we need to do all we can to show folks. See, God is tired of folks calling folks themselves Christians. But you live like Satan. Did I say that right? I'm talking about people that call themselves Christians. But you live like Satan. How many know that you make God look bad after what God? See, you feel you ought to be controlled by the beating that he took on your behalf. It should have been you on the cross. But Jesus said, I'll do it. I'll take it. Look. I got some more stuff that I got written down. These men, I got on there about these men. I'm talking about these three men. These men are part of the ministry of reconciliation. Meaning their goal is to conduct their life in a way that shows they are looking forward to seeing Jesus and will have to give an account on that day. How many know that one day you're going to have to stand before the Lord and give an account for everything you have done? So now, by you having the right information that you're getting on today, you ought to try to live in a way that when you see Jesus, when I see Jesus, when I see the one who died for me, way back on cap, will you be able to say, amen? I'm trying to give you some information that will change your life and change the way people look at you. See, when you was a sinner, or when you lived like that, you know what I'm saying? You blended in with everybody. But when you say you're a Christian, something just comes off. You ought to look different. You ought to act different. Am I making any sense up in here? You know what I'm saying? People out there look at you and say, man, there's something different about that man and about that woman. You know what I'm saying? I try my best. I try my best, you know what I'm saying? To judge me every day. Amen. I ain't trying to look at rest too. I'm looking at forward. What did I do today that did not bring glory to the Lord? You know what I'm saying? Look at the same way, see, you know, I was asking for money all morning, wasn't I? I'm trying to get money. I'm trying to get my mad people money. You know what I'm saying? But and then if there's anybody here that you might, if you leave home with $40 and you get back home, you got 15, do you want to know what a 25 went? All right. So I'm coming back, I'm trying to reverse every step. I'm trying to find out what did I do with the $25. So the same way that I want to know, what did I do today that brought glory to the Lord? What did I do today that did not bring him no glory? And then, well, because he died, I got access to saying, Lord, please forgive me for what I did today. It might be something I might not even be aware of. See, we need to pray for ourselves. Amen. Lord, please forgive me for what? So I may have done something. I may have said something. All right. Many things are serious. Do you know that we're living in the last days? So if we're living in the last days, the thing that you need to do, you need to have at least two people close to you.
I know you're right.
You know, if you got a God-fearing pastor, I need to be on your side.
All right.
You know, because I got to give an account for you. And then you need to believe. You need to believe it. You need to have Jesus on your side. You know what I'm saying? That this one gonna be able to talk to his daddy on your behalf. You know what I'm saying? And if you don't hear today, and you don't know where you will spend eternity, don't leave here today without knowing that you're saved. Amen. See, a lot of people say they saved, but they don't know how they got saved. You need to know how you get home. See, I always tell them all the time. I know how to leave here and get to spring.
All
right. So, and I know how to get to heaven.
Amen.
So if you can't tell me that, you lost.
Amen.
And if I don't know my way home from here, what am I going to do? I'm going to get lost. So if you don't know, I'm not asking you to join the church today. I'm asking you to be sure that you saved. Somebody say very sure. You know what I'm saying? That your anchor is hold and grip to the what? To that solid rock. Anybody know who the solid rock is? What's his name? This thing is serious, man. So look, God has given us enough time to carry out the desires of the flesh. You remember I told you last week about the address.
Yeah.
I know a lot of y'all don't know nothing about the address. And if you do, don't even raise your hand. You know what I mean? But it's a place around the corner, and they call it the address. It costs $25 to get in, and it costs $25 to park. So before you get inside, you done spent $50. You know what I'm saying? And then you got to buy your drink and your you know what I'm saying? So you can't go there with less than $100 in your pocket. You know what I'm saying? So what I'm saying to you, somebody here know about the address. You know what I'm saying? You ain't got to raise your hand, man. But look here. Look, my Bible tells us, say, and they be happy when they go there. But when I look at what the Sunday school lesson says, it says, enter into the gates with thanksgiving and this course with praise. See, we ought to be praising the Lord every chance we get because we are bound for the promised land. Man, I'm bound for the promised land.
Yes.
I wonder, it's a song that says, I wonder who will go.
Yes.
Or come and go with me. Yes. You know what I'm saying? I'm bound for the, I know where I'm going when I leave here.
Amen.
Because I believe in that man named Jesus.
Amen.
Amen. Look here. So I say, these men.
Yeah.
Yes, God.
I'm in my text, man. I almost do. These men. I'm talking about these three men.
Yeah.
That I'm going to ordain today. Then I'm talking to anybody else in here that don't know their way home. You ain't got to join, I don't get it. But you got to join Jesus and say, look, Jesus, I want to make sure that I'm saved today. But look, these men have been changed. How many know that Robert ain't always lived right? I'm calling Robert out because Robert told me he said he's going to have 22 people here. So I need 22 people. Somebody in here know that Robert ain't always live right. Y'all ain't got to raise your hand and tell on it. But he already told me he ain't always live right. But he's been changed. Amen. Rev Stewart ain't always live right. His mama is right and dad of me. But he's been changed. Patrick ain't never. Always. Man. He ain't always been right. But the man have been changed. I have saw a change. Y'all have seen a change in Robert. Amen. Somebody done saw a change in Reverend Stewart. Amen. Amen. Look here. I know the one that's really, really close to him. She told me, Pastor, what's her name? Her name, Bertha. She said, Pastor, he's done a great job. And I back him 100%. Now, see, y'all don't even know when to shout. Y'all don't even know when to shout. That's what his wife told me about him. So these men, I'm talking about these men. These men, my first point is found in verses 14 through 17. These men live and serve with a clean and constrained conscience.
Amen.
Praise
like
the Lord.
Huh?
Yeah.
Look what it said. Look what it said. For the love of Christ controls us. We're talking about these men.
That's right.
They look at what God done for them. And that's enough to get anybody in here to be controlled by what God did.
Amen.
God was not one that should have died.
Amen.
But he died on our behalf because he wanted us to see what kind of person he really was. He wanted us to see how much he really loved us because he wanted you to be aware one day that you need to give your life to him because he is the only one that could save you. Guess what else it said? That one died for all, therefore all died. I got on my paper that these men realized that Jesus died not only for them, but as them. Y'all missed it. Y'all missed that one, man. Y'all supposed to miss it. Jesus didn't die not only for them born, but he died as them.
Amen. Thank you.
You know what I'm saying? When Jesus died, they died.
Yeah.
When Jesus got up, when they accepted Christ, they got up. That's why your life should be different now. If you're here today and can't nobody see no change in you. Man, look at somebody out there see a change in you. It's somebody I need to see a change in you.
Amen.
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 Now, you ain't got to do everything today. But at least you can say, we can work on them words that ain't in the Bible.
Amen.
Later. You know what I'm saying? We'll take one step, you know what I'm saying? At a time, you know what I'm saying? But I need to get you saved first, you know what I'm saying? And then you can start work on you know how you tell individuals off with the words that you can't find in the Bible. If anybody here know what I'm talking about, I'm talking about them type of words that we don't need to be. We need to be a witness for the Lord everywhere we go. If you're not a witness, you're doing some damage. Does that make any sense?
Yes.
So I'm hoping that these men will not let God down.
Amen.
I'm hoping that they won't let me down.
Amen.
I'm hoping that they will continue to live with a clean and constrained conscience. See, if you ain't living right, your conscience ain't gonna be right. And guess what? When your conscience ain't right, you ain't gonna be right. You can't come in here and play with me when your conscience ain't right. See, y'all already know, man, Pastor Ford gonna be playing with you. You know what I'm saying? Yeah, when you come in the door, I don't care who you are. Man, that's who I am. I play with everybody come in the door. If you don't want to play, I can almost look at you and tell, well, I better not mess with him. I better not mess with her. You know what I'm saying? Because it's all over your face. You know what I'm saying? Because God knows how to identify people that's on his side. See, and the song says, if you're on the Lord's side. See, y'all stand up and say something. You know what I'm saying? If you're on the Lord's side. I can tell people that on the Lord's side. Or you might be on the Lord's side, but you probably did something last night. Won't cause you. See, you can't have no constrained conscience when you was at the address last night. You know what I'm saying? Has anybody here, the devil ever told you to put your hand down? Don't raise your hand. You know what I'm saying? You know how you're going to pray in the Lord, then put your hand down. You know where you were last night. Come on, help me if you can. See, you can't fool the devil. You definitely can't fool the Lord. See, we are in business to live like Christians.
Yes, sir.
I'm trying to set these men so up. I'm setting them up, man. You know? So when they leave here, they're going to say, man, Pastor Ford done put me all out on Facebook. And about 50 people in here that he done said that in front of. Look, I can't live no any kind of way no more.
Amen.
Amen. Am I making sense? Look, their conscience has to be right.
Yeah.
See, you got the right conscience.
Yeah.
You got the right spirit.
Amen.
That's why, you know why I pray so much?
Amen.
Because I used to be miserable.
All right.
I pray so much. because I'm happy with what God has done for me. Now, you know what I'm saying? Come on, help me if you can. I pray so much because I remember, see, y'all probably don't learn about this, but there used to be some times on, it's almost, you know, it's a little late, but I would be knocking on mama's window. Anybody know about mama's window? It seemed like all of them name was mama. I don't know about, that but me. I'm the only individual in here that got a drink on a Sunday morning and the liquor store wasn't open. That you had to go knock on the window. But God has delivered me from that. And that's why I'm saying, Lord, thank you in the name of Jesus. You know what I'm saying? I don't have to knock on nobody's door. God has given me a key to his front door. Shout yeah!
Yeah!
But I got to live in a way that Jesus is pleased.
That's right.
With me. You know what I'm saying? Or Ella Jones said, all you got to do is look at that little short woman over there, that little Deuce Eve.
Right.
He said, look at her. You can look at your wife.
Right.
Other people can look at her and tell what I did last night. Is there anybody here know what I'm saying? That your wife, she'll call him a wife. If you live in any kind of way at home, when you get here, they ain't gonna front with you, man. If they true Christians, they gonna say, man, look, they ain't gonna say amen when you say, can I get amen? You know what I'm saying? So what I'm saying to you on today, because this is the Lord's day. And guess what? I'm not going to tell you not take communion, but I'm saying that you need to pray and ask God to get you in the right position before you drink with him. Amen. So now my old preacher said, anywhere you go, you're in bad shape. Because if you don't take it, you're in bad shape. And if you take it in a bad manner, you're in bad shape. So the best thing for you to do is say, Lord, forgive me for what I've done last night or what I've done a few minutes ago. And participate in the Lord's Supper. See, today is the day that you should have stayed at home, man. It's Robert's fault. Robert got mostly all of y'all here today to hear this message. And there are two things that you need to remember. If you leave here unsaved, I ain't gonna blame that on Robert. That's your fault. Huh? But because you came here today because Robert invited you, that's Robert's fault. And then you hear the word. And you leave here and you act the same way. You leave out of here and you cuss somebody out. You leave out of here and you go to mama's house. Or sometimes we ain't got to go to mama. We ain't got educated now. So we just gonna buy a half a gallon. It's already at the house. You ain't got to go to nobody else's house. Come on, help me if you can. So what I'm saying to you, y'all need to really catch this. Y'all need to catch this, that if you doing that in front of your children, you know what I'm saying, your children, man, you know, they it's going to be hard for them to respect you. And then they're going to take the whooping. They're going to take all that, but they're going to be angry. Man, my mama, my dad, whooping me, all they do is sit around and drink and all and fuss and cuss and all that different kind of stuff. Probably act like they all that, then they go to church and fake, you know what I'm saying? Them children are not crazy. Oh, I'm trying to help somebody in here, you know what I'm saying? Man, these children are not crazy, man. You need to live in a way. Yeah, yeah. Now there goes my son right back there. That big old boy over there is on them drums. That guy ain't seen me drunk. Man, look here, I'm gonna come home after he sleep. I'm gonna call and say, is they still up? Man, look here, I'm not trying to be drunk and smoking and doing all this stuff in front of my children because I don't want them blaming me for them being alcoholics. But it ain't my fault. You ain't seen me do it. I'm trying to help somebody else. So y'all, we need to watch how we live. That's my first point. We need to live and serve with a clean and constrained conscience. The next thing that I see in this text, that these men, they should love and serve others because of the gift of Christ's gift, camera gift, of Christ's camera gift. See, it was a gift that God gave us on camera. That's why I got my title from the beating and the blood that God took on our behalf. So every time you get out of line, every time you just do what you want to do, every time you cuss in the job, every time you steal something, you actually, in a sense, put Christ back on the cross. You let Christ know, man, I don't care what you did for me or for anybody else, because I'm finna get that individual. I want you to know that's why so many people are dying now. Because they don't have the love of Christ in their heart. See, when you got the love of Christ in your heart, it will constrain you from doing something you really ain't got no business doing. What would it look like? I'm just asking you to be truthful with me now. You know what I'm saying? What would it look like for you to catch me? Last night at Specs. Yeah, with a half gallon of Jack Daniel. And then this morning before I got here, went and knocked on mama's window and got me another pint.
That don't look good.
How does that look as a pastor? How does that look as a believer in Christ? You say that you believe in the Lord. You say that you are born again believer. You say that you've been redeemed by his blood, but yet you live any kind of way and you let people see it. You know, I tell people all the time that you need to know how to hide well. At least you need to know how to hide well, man. You know what I'm saying? So that means that you have to be by yourself. I mean, you can't drink with nobody. You know what I'm saying? Cause they tell you, man, I ain't gonna tell nobody, but they gonna say, man, look. Tell you what Pastor was last night, man. You know? But you ain't gonna catch me.
Yeah.
You ain't gonna catch me because I've been redeemed. But at the same time, I'm not gonna look down on you because I was there. I was there. And I had some words that y'all ain't no problem. I think I was the best cusser. I know I'll get some competition on that one, brother. Because some people think that they can cuss better than me, man. But look, I think that I was in the top 10. Come on, help me if you can. So it's just kind of hard to look down on somebody else that you have participated in the same thing. And guess what? I know Robert, man. I have to rail Robert to his side. I said, man, look at Robert. But man, you're going too far, man. That man heart too big, man. You know what I'm saying? He don't care what the individual has done.
Yeah, that's right.
You see, like, yeah, that's right. You know what I'm saying? Look at I call him Robert. No, we can't go no further. Well, Pastor, no, we can't go no further. Pastor, no, man. That's the kind of man he is. You know what I'm saying? He gonna go 15 different times. And I'm trying to stop him at number 3. But he's still. I'm telling him, man, that what he does, he delays God's discipline. Because he keeps bailing these people out and they keep doing the same thing. Am I making any sense? You can't keep bailing the same individual out. Look, I work for Greenwood. I'm telling him I'm hollering today. I worked for Greenwood King, man. You know what I'm saying? I've been there 35 years. When I got saved, God gave me the job. Amen. I went in and asked them folks for a raise, man. at 30 years. I just finished this at 30 years.
Yeah.
Didn't give me a ring. I went in there, you know, they came back and said, well, let's look at your file. They came back and said, well, Anthony, you know, he said, man, look, I tried. He said, well, I just really can't justify it. Going in there, asking these folk for no more money for you. He said, number one, he had his perks and all that. He said, number one, Anthony, you know what I'm saying? You don't work for 3 days a week. I didn't think he knew that, you know what I'm saying? You know what I'm saying? Because I go in every other day, you know what I'm saying? He said, you don't work for 3 days a week. And then you ain't here for about 3 or 4 hours out of them days, you know what I'm saying? Look here, man, and we got you way up here on the pay scale already, man, you know what I'm saying? Matter of fact, and we don't even ask for no more money, man, you know what I'm saying? We're not giving you none today, and don't ask for none tomorrow, don't ask for none 15 years from now. You are already at the max. We ain't giving you nothing else. Man, look here. I left out of there now. How many know? I left out there. I'm mad.
Yeah.
But when you be quiet,
yeah,
and let the Lord talk to you,
yeah,
you say, man, that man telling you right, man. You know what I'm saying? Man, you making good money, man. You do what you want to do. You know what I'm saying? Man, you need to keep your mouth shut, man. I ain't asking for no more money.
See?
I ain't asking no more money, man. Look at, then I go back in, I say, Miss Greenwood, I sure thank you. And I heard you, and I said, I appreciate it, you know what I'm saying? See, we need to let folks know we appreciate what they have done for us, and then on top of that, you need to say, Lord, thank you for what you have done. See, we too big-headed, and we too high-minded, and we watch everybody else, but you need to be thankful for what God has done.
Amen.
You know what I'm saying? And I'll tell you what else she did. Got me in the office. Say, you need to start watching your money. We're not giving you no more advances. You know how you go in there and get advanced. Anybody besides me go get advances. They said, we're not giving you no more money in advance. You need to learn how to manage your money. Come on, help me if you can. I said, man, these folks are millionaires. They won't even give me an extra. But when I found out that they were really helping me, I left their mask. See, sometimes, you know what I'm saying, God set you up. God know how to set you up. I left their mask. You know what I said to myself? I ain't gonna never go ask them for nothing no more. And what that did, that caused me to watch my money, cause I said, I ain't had to go back, cause God, oh, look at here, God, man, God been good, man, I ain't been broke, man, look here, God have made a way for me to be happy. All discipline for the moment seems what?
Harsh.
Yet to those who have been trained by it, afterwards, it will yield,
yeah,
the peaceful fruits of righteousness. Is there anybody here living on the peaceful fruits of righteousness? You have learned how to live right. You've learned how to live holy. Is there anybody here learn how to be a godly man to show the world that you are one worth following? I believe that Robert Brown. I'm almost getting ready to get out of here, but I believe that Robert Brown, yeah, is one that people can follow.
Yeah.
Can I get 2 or 3 witnesses in the house?
Yeah.
I believe that Patrick is one that's worth following.
Yeah.
Can I get 1 witness on Patrick?
Yeah.
I believe that Reverend Kenneth Wayne stood. Oh Lord, oh Lord, yeah, is one that men and women can follow.
Yeah.
Ain't God good, Lord? But I got one more thing I want to tell you before I get out of here. Not only are these men, they love or they live and serve with a clean and constrained conscience. They also love and serve others because of Christ
Calvary gift. But if you see Robert over here doing the same, if you looked at our Patrick over on the Congo, can I get one witness here? Oh Lord, if you see Reverend Stewart over there waving his hand, it's because these men like to say, shout, serve, and pray like ambassadors. That's number four. I want number three. They love to sing, shout, serve, and pray like ambassadors. Ain't God good? Now, what is an ambassador? Ambassador is one that will testify on the behalf of somebody else. Ain't God good? That's why it's so hard to shut a lot of down. Put your head to my past. How many more songs I got? Come on, help me if you can. It's just hard to get it into you, sit down on the Lord, because they love to sing and shout. They love to wave their hand and dance. They love to let them know how good God has been to them. Can I get one witness in here? Angel, stay here. Stay here. But they love the way most preachers folk. Tell me I'm going to hear Paul Carey. Thank God, girl. Tell me that's just why. To talk about Jesus. That man, he loved to talk about Jesus. That man, we were talking about Jesus yesterday, riding in the car and all that water. But he said, boy, look, we still don't serve the Lord. Is there anybody here who serve the Lord, even in bad circumstances? He will. Robert will. But I wonder about you. What will you do in situations like that? Will you serve him? Do you really know him? If you died right now, where would you spend eternity? Yeah. Are you confident? Yeah. Do you know the plan of salvation? Yes, do you have a scripture that will verify that you're saved? Can you tell somebody? Can you lead somebody to Christ?
Yes, God.
Are you living in front of your children in a way?
Yes, Lord.
That they will say, man, my dad. You know what? As soon as this pandemic came, you know my boy, my son called me and told me. He said, Dad, you've been talking about this for a while. All my children saved. They had to live in a way before me. They couldn't stand before the church on an Easter Sunday with paper in their hand. They had no speech. Before we played basketball, we had to have Bible study.
Right.
Amen. I was hard. But my oldest boy, he's a millionaire now.
Thank you.
He didn't give me no money, he took me. He said, Daddy, I'm the man that I am because of God. I wonder what your children are saying about you.
Yes, God.
today, if you ask them to be honest and true, what are your children saying about you today? What do people say about you on your job when you go? You can call Green McKee, or you can go up there and ask them about four. Ask them four. See what they say. We got that little short lady back there. Remember that little short one? That little pretty one back there, that little pretty one. Ask her, what kind of man is your husband?
Amen.
She'll tell you. You know what she's going to tell you?
Amen.
He a little crazy, but he got a good heart. She's going to tell you he crazy, but he got a good heart. Man. You know what I'm saying? How many know that it's better to have a good heart? Than not being crazy. Yeah. But I do know the law.
Amen.
I do know the law. And you might be here today that want to have the same assurance that I got. Like I said, we're not asking you to join here. We just ask you to come up and make sure that you say, what are they saying? I want you to come, Father. Come on, Father. On Robert's Day of Ordination, Reverend Stewart's Day of Ordination, Patrick's Day of Ordination, that's the day that you got saved. When you come and get saved on today. While they say, when you come, maybe one. Then you might want to be a member here. If you want to be a member here, then come on down now. I give you two calls. Maybe one on this side. When you come. Maybe one on this side. When you come. It's just good to know that everybody's saved. Everybody in here saved, okay? That's a good thing.
Oh,
Amen, amen. Thoughts are offered. Yours to accept or reject. And we pray, God, mercy and grace upon you that he will give you enough time to make the right choice. Because it's going to be yours to give an account. Jeremy, did Sister Easton ask you what she wanted to ask you? I asked him to sing that song. And then Sister Easton gonna ask him something today. Amen. Shannon, what we got?
She said, I don't want to be here. She was saying that she don't even want to live no more. And I said, and she was like, what's my purpose? And I said, your purpose? I said, I don't know what purpose is, but you can ask God.
Yeah.
You don't need that. And then she was like, you can, we was on live on Instagram, praying for and stuff like that. And she was like, I think you're fine. And she was like, I said, I can't help you, but God, I can't, because I don't know what you're going through.
Okay.
So, my God knows what you're going through. And she was saying, I can't. I said, she said, I'm going to try to do this, I'm going to try to do that. I said, don't try to do it. Just
do it.
Right.
Make it go, talk with God, and it will work.
And I told her,
it was hard, because I said, I've never been through what you've been through.
Right, right.
But I said, God, I know that I don't know what people are going through, but if you talk to God, you can have, I would say, a better life, but a blessed life.
All right.
And me being 16 and being strong for my friends, I have my moments too.
Yeah, you do.
Yeah.
But I be strong for my friends, though, because if I was in that situation, that would be the same for me. And a friendship is nothing compared to a better friendship with God.
Thank you, TJ. Thank you.
I just want to publicly thank my wife.
What's that?
Beautiful queen, stand up. She deals with a lot with me, man. I'm a special individual. And my wife has been there since day one, man.
Thank you, God.
Even when we were just friends, she has always been the number one person in my life. And I thank God for everything you do, I'm going there. She shined for me this weekend. I ain't never had nothing like I had this weekend. But I just want to thank my wife. And I know it's your sister, Dave Robin, and River Stewart. Y'all done this on my birthday, so y'all got to eat. But I love y'all, and I thank the praise team for looking out for me. I love each and every last one of y'all. And I hope God continues to work in salvation in y'all lives.
Yeah.
No robber, Mr. Deacon. My brother is a deacon today, y'all. So thank y'all. That's it.
I want to read this scripture. I'm going to pray for y'all first. Then I'm going to read the scripture. I'm going to have a pre come up. Amen. Let us bow. Gracious Father, Lord, we come now in the wonderful and precious name of Jesus, Lord. We thank you, Lord, for Lil J.
Yeah. Yeah, God.
That's an extra extraordinary team.
Yeah.
Just standing with DJ.
Yeah.
That's an extra extraordinary team.
Yeah.
Lord, we thank you, Lord, that you have filled him with a word.
Yes.
That he was able to help his friend.
Yes.
That may even ended up in death. He saved her life.
Yes.
And hey, and even had her come close to God.
Yes.
Lord, we thank you, Lord, for using him on that day.
Yes, Lord.
And we thank you, Lord, that he's a part of the Mount Gilead Church.
Yes,
I ask you to bless his life. And Lord, we'll be so ever mindful and careful to give you all the praise, the glory, and the honor. We thank you for Patrick, Lord, that's giving thanks for this day, a day that he never thought that would come. But this is his day. So Lord, we just want you to please just accept his thanks. And Lord, we thank you, Lord, for Calvary, where you died for Jeremy, Lord.
Yes, Lord.
Lord, thank you, Lord, for dying for him, Lord, and that he recognized that he is somebody.
Yes, sir.
And we thank you, Lord, for sending treatment.
Thank you, Lord.
Lord, to show him and help him, Lord,
thank you, Lord,
in all the ways that he has been going through.
Yes.
Lord, we thank you, Lord, for all the men here, dear Lord, that didn't know Christ many years ago. But now we do. And our lives are different. Lord, we love you. We thank you.
Thank you,
we magnify and we glorify your name. It's in Jesus' name that we pray. Amen. Thank God.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Don't forget to see Sister Issa, Jen, before you leave. Robert, we're going to do the ordination first. So Robert will have a chance to do serve communion.
Amen.
Amen.
Today. I'm the one that always plans stuff. I just don't get up and do no anything. I've been had Robert on my spirit all this week.
Amen.
And, he just cried not to open. When I told him that, I asked him, man, Robert, if you don't thought about being a deacon. Just ask him a question. I was crying out my office, man. I said, man, I'm gonna get some help in here. He was just so happy. And he said people that would come, they were coming to see this.
Yes.
Because Robert, he's a great man.
Yes,
a gifted man.
Yes.
Just thank him for being a part of the Mount Gilead Church. And never knew that he was going to come. David brought Robert here.
Yeah.
Oh, David on that day. And he just kept on coming. Next thing you know, he came up.
Yeah.
And he's been here ever since. I've been watching him.
Amen.
So I watch everybody because I got to give an account for you.
Amen.
That's why I watch you like a hawk, you know what I'm saying? I just can't tell you nothing, me.
Right.
Amen.
Amen.
I think, you know, I always tell folks, man, I ain't scared of you. I got three people behind me, you can't even see.
I can't move.
So we thank God for Robert, that we want Patrick to come. Extraordinary young man.
Praise the Lord, Pastor.
Just like me, sometimes he has problems with his words. Not a great teacher. But I don't see nowhere in the Bible what it says for a deacon to be a teacher.
Right.
You know, man, if you find it, show me. But those are not the qualifications for a deacon to teach. Those are for pastors and elders. But when it comes to having a great heart and doing things around this church, opening up, serving, Patrick is at the top of the list. Amen. So that's why I'm ordaining Patrick as on the head deacon. He's not just a deacon, he's the head deacon. Because he's been here since he's been here, he's been working. Now he will teach, but that's not one of his own qualifications. Amen. And then we have the eagle. I call him the bald eagle.
Yeah. Amen.
And what do we have to do? Why he's so special that everybody else gonna come up and he gonna stand over there? I have so much trouble. I have so much trouble out of the eagle, man. But the eagle ain't nothing he wouldn't do for you.
Amen.
His heart is big as his room.
Yes, sir.
And boy, he loves him some birth.
Amen.
That man, if you pick up ice chest full of cans, just wonder what he'll do if you do some birth. Ooh, Lord have mercy. Man, pray about birth. He loves his family.
Yes, sir.
And you know, I ain't scared to tell the truth. Frank is his favorite. He loves all three of them.
All six.
All six of them, you know. But Frank is his favorite. I mean, know that Jesus loved all the disciples.
Yeah.
But John was his favorite.
Yeah.
Amen. So ain't nothing wrong with that.
Yeah.
Amen. So they all gonna get ordained today. I want to read 2 Timothy chapter 2, verse number 24. For you all, they're gonna come give you your ordination papers, and then you're gonna line up and you're gonna go down the middle.
Amen.
Amen. That Molly gonna be on my side. Verse number 24 says, the Lord's bond servant must not be quarrelsome. Y'all are bond servants. But be kind to all. Amen. Patient when wrong. With gentleness, correcting those who are in opposition.
Yeah.
If perhaps God may grant them repentance, leading to the knowledge of the truth. And they may come to their senses and escape from the snare of the devil, having been held captive by him to do his will. Amen.
Amen.
Remember what I've read to you all. Anybody can fuss.
Yeah, man.
Cuss and all that. Just a few minutes, not earlier today, Reverend Dillon was here. You know, when me and him get together, there's going to be some stuff. But the man across me, we both got some songs. They were looking. Because they didn't know what was going on. But I always say, if me and Robert walking down the street together, and me and them arguing and cussing, who will they think the Christian is?
Right.
Amen.
Mm-hmm. So we got to watch how we act.
That's right.
In front of people.
That's right.
Amen. And if I ever see that man again, I'm going to tell him, this man, that was one of my preachers. We talk about that all the time. You got to always be able to get an excuse. The way that you act.
Amen.
Amen. I mean, no dealer, he'll take you there every now and then.
Amen.
I got this that I want to read. This is for Reverend Kenneth Stewart. We the undersigned. Upon the recommendation and request of the Mount Gilead Missionary Baptist Church at 1606 Cadillac, Houston, Texas, 770-21, which had full and sufficient opportunity for judging the God-given gifts, and after satisfactory examination by us in regard to the Christian experience, called to the ministry and views of Bible doctrine that verified that Reverend Kenneth Stewart was solemnly and publicly set apart and ordained to the work of the gospel ministry of the Mount Gilead Missionary Baptist Church at 6806 Cadillac, Houston, Texas, 770-21, on the third day of October 2021, signed by Pastor Anthony Wayne Fuller, by Elder Michael Briscoe, by Elder Audrey Carter, by Elder Gary Holly, and by our 90-year-old preacher. Reverend Nation. Amen. Amen. And that you will work out the little soul salvation. Yes, let people know that you are worthy of the certificate that you have received.
Yes, God. Amen. Amen.
Reverend Dick Crowder, you are saying the same thing. I mean, a great example of what a head deacon should be doing on yesterday when we were working together. I told him, Pat, I said, now just stand right there. Do not move. Because we had fire cabinets. I said, if you hit one of them walls, it's going to be my fault. Because you helping me. I said, them folks don't know about no Patrick. They're going to say, Anthony, what happened to the walls? I can't say Patrick. You know what I'm saying? It's my fault. So if you the head deacon, if anything go wrong around here, you can't blame Remy's. Huh? The only scapegoat you got is Elder Briscoe, Elder Holland, Elder Carter. You got to tell me that, well, if Briscoe said do it, you're off the hook. Holland said do it, you're off the hook. Carter said do it, you're off the hook. But if Rev Meeson said do it, you're in trouble. Because these are your bosses, Holland, Briscoe, Carter, Elder, Edmund Jones, and me. So you ain't got no excuse. Amen?
Amen.
Here we got Robert Lee. Is it Lee? Robert Lee Brown. Or Robert Crybaby Brown. That man cried like a baby, man. He's about to cry now.
It's all good. Good tears.
He's about to cry right now, man.
All right,
but,
Lord.
Man. Sister Ruben said, Robert, Pastor Ford must thank a whole lot of you. I said, well, I do.
Yes,
I do. Me and him always. Ain't nobody here that I agree everything with. I don't know, I'm all here. But I got to stand and give an account for you.
Yeah.
God's going to ask me, what did Robert do? I said, well, Lord, I tried. But he wouldn't listen. I can't lie for him.
Yeah.
So I want you to keep on doing what you're doing.
Yes, God.
I want you to listen more. And I want you to, every now and then, I know you love music. Turn your radio off at least 15, 20 minutes a day and just listen for God.
Yes.
And talk to you. He got something to say to you.
Yes,
but he can't get through because the music is loud and all that. But I want you to work out your soul salvation. And you want to help everybody. But some of these people you can't help. You help them, you help them, then when they keep doing the same thing. They tell me, I can't use that word. But they said, that word. But keep on doing the same thing. Expecting different results. You know what the Bible said we shouldn't call them? Y'all know that word I'm talking about.
Insanity, Pastor.
Huh? Insanity?
Well,
the Bible called me something like that. Look at so many people you can't help. I ain't telling you to stop helping, but once you do it a couple of times and keep doing the same thing, you need to move on.
Amen.
Amen. Because you're delaying that discipline. So you act like you don't want them. I'm trying to get to you. You don't want it. We thank God for all of you.
Yes, God.
And we're going to prepare for communion. And I hope y'all will stay and join us. Amen.
Thank you.
Lord, to say we come, Father, we bow down here and submit to heart to give you thanks, Lord. Thanking you, Lord, for enabling us to gather here today and participate in the Lord's Supper, Lord. Lord, we just come right now, praise, Lord, searching our hearts, Father, knowing that something we said or did, Lord, to ask for repentance of our sins, Lord, and ask for forgiveness of our sins before taking this Lord's Supper, Lord. We ask that you forgive us of our sins. Cleanse our soul, Lord. Create us a clean heart and renew the right spirit, Father. Make us worthy of taking this Lord's Supper. We thank you, Lord, for dying on the cross that we be saved, Lord. And you ask that we do this in remembrance of you, Father. We pray it all in your daughter's son's name, Jesus. Amen. Thank God.
Amen.
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 At Calvary.
Stand, please. Now I want to take this time to give you a moment of silent prayer. And it's in Jesus' name that we pray. Amen. For I received from the Lord, that which I also delivered to you, that the Lord Jesus, the night in which he was betrayed, took bread. And when he had given thanks, he broke it and said, "This is my body, which is for you. Do this in remembrance of me." In the same way, he took the cup also after supper, saying, "This cup is the new covenant in my blood. Do this as often as you drink it in remembrance of me. For as often as you eat this bread and drink the cup, you proclaim the Lord's death until he comes. Amen.
Amen.
We want to thank you for being here today. Thank all the Robin's guests. And we do have food on the other side. Amen.
Amen.
I just want to say something to the teens. The women had 10 people in Sunday school, so they won. The men had 8. And the kids had 8. But the teens, we didn't have many teens. We're asking that you bring the teenagers to be taught by an educated young lady by the name of Erica Hockpun, which is a school teacher, and she knows the word of God. So we ask you to bring your teens on next Sunday to be a part of our Sunday school class. Amen.
Amen.
You are this.
Good evening. Thanks, first of all, to God. We have our pastor's anniversary coming up. Just a reminder, October 24th. I have envelopes here. It's a shoe size drive. It helps with your $200 that we're asking for each member. Take this to your employment or friends. And if you need any of these, Shantae will distribute them. It's normally if someone just say you're calling a person wears a size 10, then they'll give 10. They might be a 20, but it's a shoe size drive, and it's for Pastor Ford's anniversary, and we need to do the best we can. Pastor Ford helps everybody. We just love our pastor. We want to show him that. So please, if you need envelopes, Chante is out in the fellowship hall to give you these, okay? Our date is October 24th, so time is winding down. We only have, what, 3 more Sundays, I think, and that's it.
Amen.
So thank you, and I just wanted to announce that, and Sister Bill.
I have a quick announcement as well. On October 16th, at the hour of 4 to 6, we will be having ladies and men. We will have a tea. It's a tea in Paris. So we are asking that if the women will be wearing hats and pearls and just dress it down, dress it up. And men will wear ties. Please, I'm asking you if you would attend. There will be gifts given and all, but it's also for our pastor's, toward our pastor's anniversary. And we plan to have a very elegant and nice time that evening. So we will be announcing it probably again, but we would love to have everyone attend because our pastor is one of the best there is. Trust me on that. Amen.
I'll dismiss.